You know where you are?
This is Nollywood Picturestv.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the time that we've been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting to you the models from the house of Sapphire, Sapphire Gloves, ladies and gentlemen. Come on. Come on. This is something else. Yeah, baby. Rock it, baby. Rock it, man. Yes, this is creativity, ladies and gentlemen. Come on. Sapphire Gloves, ladies and gentlemen. Sapphire Gloves. Come on, let's go. Stop it. Please, a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, this is the hot stuff. This is the hot stuff, ladies and gentlemen. This is hot.
All right, baby.
Come on. Ladies and gentlemen. This is good. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, this is another creativity here. Ladies and gentlemen, another one. This is another creation.
This is Africa, ladies and gentlemen. Let's have it for
Nifama.
Come on! This is good!
From the house of Sapphire! Sapphire clothing, ladies and gentlemen! And now, one more time, let us have it! For the design of the year, Sapphire clothes! Ladies and gentlemen! Alright!
There she comes!
Alright! This is creativity, ladies and gentlemen! Ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Come on. Come on.
Thank you very much. That's my husband. It's an honor to be here. I'm glad to be here. But before I start, I want you to meet two very important people. First of all, I'd like you to meet my brother-in-law, Phil. Take a bow. A round of applause for him. And I would also like you to meet the love of my life, my heartbeat, the man I love so much, my husband, Oasis. A round of applause for him, please. This one's for you. Okay.
Oh,
si wa bi ya because mo ya won is and everywhere I'm going bo ya asuka si wa bi ya because mo ya say me
too, but I didn't have a heart to wake you. You were sleeping just like a baby. You looked so innocent.
No, you should have woken me now. You know, I have a meeting with the manager of Montana too. I'm singing there tonight.
Sweetheart, come to cancel that one. At least you were well paid for singing at yesterday's function. Huh? Let's stay at home today. Spend the whole day in bed.
As tempting as that sounds, you know we can. We need all the money we can get now until your business picks up.
Sweetheart, my business will pick up sooner than you know. And you'll never have to sing in clubs or any other function.
But I enjoy singing.
I know. But I don't like the way men look at you anytime you mount a stage to sing. I'll get back on my feet. And you won't have to handle any microphone again. Huh? You'll be loved and pampered the way you were meant to be. I don't know why all those stupid men duped me.
No, enough. Enough of this self-pity. Okay, what has happened has happened. We can't change the situation. Let's just be thankful that God has blessed me with the talent. At least I can help in putting food on the table. Besides, I enjoy singing and I'm even considering taking it seriously.
Hell no. Let's not even go there, okay? Because we're not going to discuss it.
Okay. But please, let me just go and do this show. Okay, the money is too good to pass up. Remember, we need a new car.
Why me? Why is this happening to me? Why is it? Why would God allow my wife be the one to bring bread to the house?
Don't. Why don't talk like this now, eh? This is only for a while. If we don't go through things like this, we won't be strengthened. This is just preparing us for greater storms ahead that we will eventually face anyway. The most important thing is that we love each other. It doesn't matter who brings food to the table or who doesn't.
Whatever did I to deserve you?
We deserve each other. God sent me to you. And he sent you to me to love and cherish. I love you. I love you too.
Okay, time to eat. Now see what I did. Ta-da! Alright, baby.
Breakfast in bed.
Yeah, breakfast in bed.
Right.
Loose in the world like this.
Huh? Yeah,
your sweet tongue feel. No wonder all the women flock around you like bees. I'll talk to him again. But when I get home, I'll...
You do that.
But I need to go. I'm really tired. And you need to go. Because I'm sure that all your women are waiting for you and they're impatient.
They can wait. You mean the world to me. I mean to us, my brother and I. Yeah? Come on, walk with me. So how much did you get paid for this?
Ivie, drop the subject. I have told you I will not entertain any discussion on this matter ever again.
But Oasis, I don't see anything wrong in letting your brother help you. It's your elder brother we're talking about here, not an outsider. So what's your problem?
My problem is you don't know when to back off. Phil has been helping me since I was a little boy. Isn't it about time I learned to face my own responsibilities? I will make it again. Without Phil's help, without your help, without any damn help from anybody for that matter.
Honey, this your macho stuff will not get you anywhere. Whether you believe it or not, we all need each other's help sometimes. And if your wealthy brother wants to help you get back on your feet again, I don't see why you shouldn't let him do it.
You're really getting me mad. Ivie, I'm going to ask you once again to please drop the subject.
Oasis, please listen.
Drop the subject! What's the matter with you this morning? Have you gone nuts? I told you I don't want any discussion on this matter again. I was not in support of your singing. But since you insist, fine. If you are tired of it, stop. Nobody built this house for me. I did it. I didn't need any family's help. And I'm gonna do it again. With family or without family.
Saying I don't want to ever see you again. I'm just, for me, listen to me. I'm just saying I don't like women that cling on to me, okay? Have some self-respect and hey, okay? It's not your business who I'm going to be with, all right? I'm getting off this. Hey, Yasmin, baby, what's going on? I'm good. No, I can see you at 2. No, yes. I'll see you, say, about 8. Okay? Yes, I gotta go. Hey, Angelica, baby, what's going on? No, I'm still coming. I'll see you at 2, you know? Just keep it warm, okay? I'm cool. I'll call you back. Hello? Fumi? don't call me. I will call you. Women. Give them a yard. They want to take the whole.
Why are you looking so gloomy. Phil, I want you. You don't allow things to deteriorate before coming to see a doctor. You must be coming for usually a normal checkup all the time. Your health is not something you joke with, okay?
I just haven't had this kind of experience before.
Come on, take it easy. It's no problem. I'll take care of everything. Yeah, as soon as the results of the test comes out, I'll let you know. Meanwhile, I'll give some drugs that will help ease the congestion in the chest, okay? But please, Phil, discontinue smoking, please. Those fancy cigarettes of yours, discontinue taking them. It's injurious to your health. No more taking them, please, Phil. Do you understand me? You'll be all right, okay? You don't have to worry. I'll take care of everything now.
So my sister, I believe it. There's going to be a revival in this land after that meeting.
Yes, that is what we need in this village, so that all these wishes will disappear. I heard that Ma Amaka was attacked by a strange wolf that lasted 12 months. And people have already started saying it's Amaka, who is known everywhere as a witch.
Ife Yuma, why are you so worried about witches? I have told you that their powers can never be above the children of God. Eh? Look, we are bought by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. So no principalities, no power. The next day we laid hands on her. All the strange diseases and sicknesses disappeared. Hallelujah.
Hey, what about Oduwa and those sister youngsters? Have you heard from them?
Yes, my dear. They are fine, though. It's just that my eldest son, Oduwa, has refused to settle down. But I still believe God. He will do it for me.
What of Oduwa's wife? Is she pregnant yet?
I don't know. The last time I spoke with Oduwa, he didn't say so. So I don't know. But I still believe God. My Bible tells me that none shall be barren amongst us. And none of my children will be barren in Jesus' name.
Amen. Okay, yes. Our God has never failed us. Never. He will never fail us.
Never.
Yes. All you need to do is let them get closer to God.
That's all. I'm doing my best, my sister. I have put everything into the hands of God.
I've been trying to call you for the past 2 hours.
I'm
sorry. My battery wasn't fully charged.
You could have gone to a business center to call me or send a text or something.
See, it didn't even occur to me. I'm sorry. I was so engrossed with the children at the home that I lost track of time.
Children?
Yes. The children at Motherless Baby's home.
The Motherless Baby's home?
Remember the day we talked about adoption now?
If I remember correctly, you did all the talking. I just listened.
Honey, don't you think we should start thinking of adoption?
Obviously. Since you've done most of the thinking, definitely you've taken a decision. So tell me, how many have you adopted? Or don't I have the right to know that one too?
Don't talk like this now. The owner of the home just called me that I should come and look at some babies that they just brought in. They were just abandoned.
And you didn't think it wise as a wife to come home first and discuss with your husband before taking a decision? What even makes you think that I agreed to the idea of an adoption in the first place?
Oasis, we've been married for over 4 years. All I want is just to feel my own baby in my arms. The house is too silent. I want to hear the cry of a baby.
How very maternal. But I'm sorry to disappoint you, my dear. My paternal instincts are not kicking as much. Especially when the child is not coming from my loins.
But you cannot father a child now. The best thing we can do in these circumstances is to adopt.
Adoption is not an option.
Then what is our option? What is it? I'm frustrated. You're just killing me. You're the one that does not have a job. You're the one that doesn't want to take help from anybody. You're killing everybody. You're the one who is being protected.
Your fault. The fault is mine. It's my fault. But we can't go around town announcing it, can we? Maybe. I don't know. I don't know why God had to let this happen to me. People suffer from worms without devastating side effects. I don't know why mine left me impotent. God, why had to let this happen?
It's okay. But since everything is like this now, why don't you just go and adopt?
No. Adoption is not an option.
For goodness sake, Ivie, what's wrong with you? Why the sudden loss of concentration?
Look, I'm sorry, okay? I'm truly sorry. I think we should take a break. I can't concentrate anymore. Please.
What do you mean you can't concentrate? Do you know what we stand to lose if we do not perform on Saturday?
I know, but the truth of the matter is that I can't do this right now, okay? Let's do it tomorrow. The guys aren't even here. The band is not even complete. They're not here, so let's just...
What do you mean, let's do it tomorrow? That's what you said yesterday. Today you're saying the same thing again. What's all this now?
Are you the only one that has problems? Everybody has problems. Yeah. You have to put your problems aside so that we can forge ahead. We can't mess up this show, we can't. Let's start again, okay? Let's start again.
Look, Chichi, you can't flog a dead horse. There's nothing we can do to bring her out of this mood. You know what I think we should do? Let's do this tomorrow.
Look, guys, I'm sorry.
At this rate, I hope the show holds on Saturday. So please, pull yourself together so that we can get busy.
Well, hold, I'm sorry, okay? I promise you tomorrow it'll be better, okay? Please.
It's okay. These things still happen. But you see, whatever it is, please, pull yourself together and let's get done with this thing, okay? The show for Saturday is good. Don't let's miss it.
Okay,
please.
Fine. We won't miss it, but we'll do it, alright? I promise you tomorrow. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
You know what? Let me buy you a drink, okay?
No. Thank you.
Just... 6 months to live? Are you sure you heard the doctors right?
I'm afraid I did. We had to do the test over and over again, and after a series of tests, they all confirmed the same thing. It's there in black and white. Cancer of the lungs also confirmed.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. What are we going to do now?
I don't know, Oasis. I don't know. I'm still too shocked. The doctors insist, though, that I must check in tomorrow.
What?
To continue the treatment.
Oh,
commence the treatment.
God.
Hospital tomorrow.
Oh, God. Jesus. 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 Jesus Christ. Oh, no. No, no, no. How is Mama going to take this? How is Mama going to take this?
Look. Voices. Voices, please. Don't. You can't afford to break down now. Alright? I need your strength. In 6 months, I'm out of here. And the leadership of this family rests squarely on your shoulders.
Please, stop saying this!
I'm on my way out.
You are my brother! I cannot let you go! You can't die! You can't! You can't! God, why is this happening to us? Why?
Brother, for God's sake.
Asking God to explain to me how I'm going to break this news to Mama. It's just asking
sweetie,
God.
Sweetie, let's not tell Mama anything yet. If you don't believe in miracles, I still do.
What's the matter with you guys? Why are you behaving like you're in a mortuary? Life is beautiful. And I've had a good life.
Yes, yes, Philip, I agree with you. Life is beautiful. And every moment of it must be celebrated. And that's why we brought lots of stuff for you, okay? We have fruits, we have wine, we have lots of things.
But you know, I can't eat much because doctors are just...
Okay, then we'll wait for you to get well, catch up from here, leave this hospital and come back home, okay? You will get well and you will come out of here.
Yeah. I wish I had your faith, but unfortunately I don't. So I'm just gonna stay here and die. And hey, do you know what I'd love to wear when I die? I'd love to wear a white tuxedo, you know? White fedora. Oh,
just
shoes.
Stop, please.
So, I have to tell him to come to terms with the reality on the ground. Okay. I've lived my life, and I have absolutely no regrets. Oops. I do have one regret. I'm gonna miss you again. You are by far the most important thing that happened to me, to us, my brother and I, my family. Well, promise me one thing, that you take care of my brother.
Stop it.
You will love
him. Stop it. I don't want to listen to this anymore. I refuse. I refuse to be drawn into this pessimism by both of you. Philip, you will get well. You will get well, you will walk out of this hospital and you will come back home alive. You will get well, so stop talking rubbish! Because you will come back. Listen, as for Oasis, I'm going to take care of him because he's the love of my life. But you will come back home. You will get well and come back home. Do you hear me?
Okay.
I brought some CDs for you to watch, okay? This one is Promise Me Forever. And you're going to promise me that you will be alive to watch it again and again. This is it, you. You're going to watch.
Mrs. Osondo, how are you today?
I'm fine, thank you.
I don't think you've overstayed.
I know, I'm fine. I'll come back tomorrow.
It's alright, it's okay.
Please, take care of him for me, for us.
Oh, he's in the best of hands. You do not have to be perturbed, okay?
Thank you.
Yeah, I think he needs some rest now, eh? Bye.
Thank you.
Yeah, Phil, how are you today?
How are you, sir?
I broke my fingers. Let's get his injection.
Okay.
But you shouldn't eat it wrong, man. You did amazing so well.
Yes. My chest is clearing up a little bit.
That's the way it is right now.
What do you mean you won't be able to sing at the show? Do you realize the implication of what you're saying?
I know. Listen, I know you guys can handle the show alone. I'm having serious problems right now. I can't face an audience. I can't.
Look, we are a team, Ivie.
Yes.
We can't just stand there singing without
exactly.
You. Manager is not going to find this funny. How can you cancel at the last minute?
Please now, you guys, just plead with him for me. You know what I'm going through. I'm emotionally drained. My brother-in-law lies dying in the hospital and it's making my husband go mad. Coupled with the fact that I cannot have a child. I mean, how can I be singing with all these on my mind? Listen, when all these blows are over, I promise you guys that we will definitely sing together again. Okay?
I wonder when that will be, Ivie. Look, you better sit up. What is it? Everyday problems? Problems left, right, center, Ivie. I'm tired, please. I'm tired of all this, okay? If your husband and his people are giving you problems, keep them aside and let's forge ahead. We can't get to the top at this rate now.
How about Chichi? How insensitive can you get? I mean, is everything about stardom to you?
Of course. What else is there to think of? Look, whether you guys like it or not, this babe is out to take the world by storm. So it will be in both of your interests to follow my footsteps. Girls, we need to rehearse. We cannot get to the top at this rate, okay? We need to rehearse. Myself, I'm tired of all this. You have problems every day. The other day you said we're going to rehearse. Now again, you're changing it.
Chichi.
Look, I am not part of this, okay? I am not part of this.
Chichi.
Call me when you're ready.
Chichi. Look, don't worry. Don't worry. Everything will be fine. Believe me.
I pray so. I really hope so, you know, because there is a very thin line between sanity and insanity. And believe me, Angel, I'm hovering between that line right now.
God forbid. You're a strong woman, Ivy. And that strength will carry you through. Just believe in God. God will help you. Okay?
Okay,
Ivy. Okay? Everything will be fine.
Gigi, I'm getting tired. I think you should leave. You know we are ready today.
Of course.
But well, I hope you didn't come. Not once, I don't understand her. She's losing it. That's what happens when you allow a man to revolve around your life. That her husband is giving her too much stress. I'm telling you, this marriage is just a lot.
If you marry before, if you know it's wrong, what's a lady supposed to do that?
You see this man? The first thing is just to use them for procreation. Have your children and move on. Living with this man is really, really frustrating.
You can say that again. Look at that poor girl. Ever since she got married to Stuart, it's been two problems together.
I'm
telling you, the young man is not even keen on singing anymore. Because of one stupid guy. Imagine if we had continued the way we started. We would have been stars by now. Destiny's child, Spicer, will not come near us. The right man our world is crashing because of one stupid man.
What's your home now? You really hate these voices of a man? Or are you jealous that she's married and you're
I beg your pardon. Jealous for what? Look, no one has come to say. I'm here to be
Is there anything you need? Anything we can do to ease your pain?
I have everything I need. Little brother, thank you. I've lived a very good life. I've enjoyed myself and I have absolutely everything I need. I've willed everything to you and Ivie. Alright. I do have one little regret though. I wish I had a child.
I regret that too. Especially as I may never be able to have a child of my own.
I have thought about nothing else but that. Ever since I found myself in this situation.
You go now and I go. It will mean the family name will be completely wiped out.
They did.
Are you sure none of your many women got pregnant for you?
They did. But I always made sure they had the children aborted or they went through abortion. I wish I had kept some of those pregnancies, man. I wish I did.
God.
Oasis.
Yeah?
Just had an idea. Maybe we can do something about this.
Something?
Yeah. Maybe. If he can't carry my child for you.
I don't understand.
Yeah. I can get if he pregnant. That way she can carry the child, have the child for you. And when she does have the child, people will think that it is yours. And I'll be dead anyway.
Are you referring to IVF or artificial insemination?
No. I still have some little strength in me. I think that those IVF things, they take too long. Maybe I can still do it the natural way. And then when she has the child, it will be between you, Ivie herself and myself, and not even Mama will know. Everything will be done behind closed doors.
I don't believe I am hearing this. You are saying this. Phil, are you crazy? Huh? How dare you say this? How can you say this? How dare you?
What? You can't father a child. And if you desperately need one, and here I am. I'm not going to be able to do that. And once the child comes along, everybody is happy and the family lineage continues. That's all.
I am now convinced the sickness has gone to your mind. If you were not lying there helpless on the bed, I swear, elder brother or not, sick bed or not, dying or not, you in the face!
What have I done?